So doesn't say a lot about how he handled Griffiths, but still says a lot about how he handles Bayonetta in general.
So Sonny Luther just start. Let's see what will happen in that first match. The world set will be full of surprise, pretty sure of it. Nice move by Alexia in front of Lee. Oh, yeah, the side B of Grand Ninja will really allow him to get away of that combo.
Absolutely. The up B in particular, being a multi-hit move, is the one move that will be the escape route of Grand Ninja. These combos still leaves him quite open, so the Bayonetta player can adapt to what he's doing. And again, on the jab.
On that up B, unfortunately. Nice catch on that roll, that side B of Griffith. Steamed some bullets. Nice up B just on landing and neutral air of Alex Yao. But if only won't go so far. Nice spacing. Catching him that upper landing and finally missed the down tilt. Wrong way.
Very patient play from Greninja, from Alex Yao. He really doesn't want to hit into any witch time shenanigan.
Nice. Giving some distance already. Griffith wanted to get closer to make that counter. Maybe, as you said, to get closer on the project eye to counter it. But starting with that LB double side B back air, a good amount of percent. Nice back air once again, that jump.
Whoa, went for some tricky side B on the edge to a pair. Nice. And again, the up B will not be able to connect off of it. And again,
side B. Thank you to making you so up in the air. Now I'm gonna side B you and steal your stock. Really nice,
really unfortunate. We'll see how Danny handles that. Will he even change his game plan? Will he give up on the up B combos, or will he just assume that it was just a fluke? It's obviously been the only time that we've seen Alex Yao take a stock off of his side B. Usually it was used as a defensive tool. Right now it also serves as a kill move, so we'll see how Griffiths deals with that.
The other won't reach him this time. Whoop. Nice.
Okay, side B. 107%, this will be the nice smash. All these promos are really unnecessary.
Yeah, I agree, way too much. Maybe he wasn't that close of the edge, you know, he wasn't on the top, so maybe he wanted to make some permanent out. And no rage. Oh!
This should be it, even with the moving platform. Yep, kills off the top with the front throw.
So, Griffith a bit behind, but not that much.
Okay, up throw back here.
Nice day tilt. Trying to catch that day tilt, maybe gonna be stuck for some things.
Yeah, this might actually be a thing against Greninja, since he's boss fast follower.
Whoa,
what the hell?
Make him under the stage, but Greninja got a really nice upbeat, so not trouble for him to get back on stage. Oh, just a little bit above him.
Dive kick very hard to punish, you need to be very aware of Bennett as a... Oh, this might be it. No, it won't be it.
Oh, no, too bad! But with those kind of person, he cannot just throw smash and get the stock. He really needed to start something out.
Yep. And he tried with his up B, but still couldn't get anything off of it as Alex Yao dragged behind because of the slow.
Nice dash tech. Space move that fair. Nice double side B back here right after it. Still off stage. Neutral air. Really nice.
So I'm not sure if it's actually Griffith's adaptation to Greninja side B, or just because he didn't have any enough percent. But right there, Griffith hasn't gone into any up B combos off of side B's. He just goes for side B back air, which is something that Greninja cannot side B out of.
Oh, nice air. The throw right after. Waiting a bit. Oh, nice wait by Alex Yao. No witch time. Really nice catch with that grab by Alex Yao.
Not confident into his up throw knockback, chose to go for a front throw, and this time he will go for it and take the stock. Greninja with a lot of percent on, this could be it.
No.
Whoa, no side B. I'm surprised. Either he had too much percent and it's like at one point it stopped being true, this escape tool, or either he just didn't go for it and tried to DI it.
The one that F throw, maybe this time would be enough, and still not. And shot some bullets! One stock match, Griffith XO on that first match of that semi losers.
Okay, Griffith being stuck at the edge, goes for the side kick. Dive kick, very safe option. If you hit the opponent's shield, you're, well, basically impossible to punish. Very nice jab.
Even though with the side B, still hit him.
Yeah, it's sometimes too slow to cover these multi-hit moves.
Forcing him to shield that D-neutral, rolling back.
Oh, kick will not get punished inside me. And yeah, I was wondering, this is actually a thing. Greninja is a fast follower, so if you hit him with only the first hit of side, ground inside B, he needs to tech on the ground. He doesn't even have a fast aerial, like a sex kick, to cover his landing. He basically really has to tech and be tech chased.
They're really hard. They try to find a way to get in. Elixir finally get a grab, but Griffith already back on stage. Nice side B up, I gotta say. He wasn't on the ground, he just get a little bit in the air, avoiding the counter attack of Elixir. But well, let's talk about it later, because Elixir right now!
Nice up smash, goes right underneath Griffith, reads one of his rare down airs, and nearly takes the stock off of it.
Nice fair side B, nope. And for the lead, don't send Elixir too far enough to get in on the up B.
And this is very pleasing to watch, because we're seeing Elixir take advantage of one of Bayonetta's only real and huge weaknesses, which is her landing lag after she uses specials in the air. He's been sitting right outside of Griffith's range for a couple of occasions now, and right there, just in range, so that the dash options like a dash grab will allow him to get the punish.
Yeah, Griffith now is just...
And again!
Wow! That up throw won't be enough, but maybe the next one. Side B, oh, he gets it, but no, nope. Won't lead to a can. Finally, that wish time is still making that up B. Nope. Still not enough. Trying to spin that back here, the back throw. Takes you in a bad situation, Griffith wanted it so bad!
Oh, nice take! And again! Very, very good takes by Elixir. Wow. It's not like Griffith has been going for these either. There's a back throw at the edge, might be it again!
Shot fired!
And Griffith gets up, pops off, bumping his fist into the air. Wow, this was very, very good play. And like, Elixir will take both of these front air ones. And what is this other, like, front air? You'd expect something like the down air or perhaps the neutral air, like he did earlier. And both fairs, Elixir went for the tech. Very good reaction time. It's not like, as I was saying, Griffith used this option much in the rest of the set.
So let's go back on Smashville, but what a close first match! It's still to 1-0 for Griffith, but nothing is done yet. Elixir staying completely trapped on that side, and Griffith starting with a pretty good punish!
And this is too bad! Griffith overcommitted so hard on this combo, he just lost track of the drown and lost his stock for it. Well, this is pretty bad, but still, some decent percent right now. 80% on Greninja as Griffith tries to find an opening. And nice the dive kick B. to down air, very nice.
Mr. Side B, but still safe. Finally, Xiao putting some hit on Griffith. Trying to space bit, forcing him to jump, but nice fast fall, avoiding the full jump fair by Xiao, but now still get the grabs, get some punish out of it. Waiting a bit. Oh, missed the grab from quite nothing, finally.
And slowly but surely, Elixir is making sure that he's... that his lead is increasing even further. Griffith finds something! And right now the down smash with the ult from the eye sends Griffith towards the bottom of the stage.
Elixir was really waiting, really patiently. He wanted so bad. Nice up throw, making another pair, maybe a little bit too early on that air dodge. And Griffith making a really great avoid, making a good back here, but Elixir still managed to make it back on stage. Griffith wait a bit, and then the troller still taking!
Whoa, the up B nice being dragged off by Greninja's water pump allows him to punish Greninja's water pump when he was in the middle of the stage.
Nice roll, but ooh!
Wow, the reeds are real.
Get away! Get away! But no, thank you the platform.
The smashing platform. Smash Force Randall.
Nice roll. Oh, just crawl! Just crawl! Side B upper, thank you! So 100% on Griffith, really hard.
Yeah, he might actually lose his stock to one of Elixir's good openings, like this neutral air. And this up smash on the side B! This was a very poorly spaced side B by Griffiths. It might actually have been a bait from Elixir, seeing how he moved a little back and forth before Griffiths went for the side B.
Nice jab. Oh, and the side B, just between those jabs, really nice. Still catching the fair back a bit behind him. Trying to punish me? Dude, I got my up B.
Wow, this is very impressive to see that Green Ninja might be actually one of the characters with answers to Bayonetta. This dash grab allowing him to stay just out of range and still punish her laggy landings when she uses specials. His side B being a counter to her combos.
Nice fair, side B. Oh, and for him there's a platform. I'm pretty sure he didn't want to land on it. That was close, could have been the stock on that side B. Nice up tilt, the upper, up B. Landing first, but nice neutral by Elixir. In front of the jumped on that side B, but still living now. And the neutral air to fair. I'm back.
Well, I'm not too sure about this up B, by the way, because Bayonetta never goes into free fall mode. So when Elixir uses his up B to drag a dagger on the stage,
jump.
Wow, great DI by Elixir.
Wow! I take all your move, but you're not even able to take one of mine! 1-1 now. So what are you saying about them?
Yeah, what a pump. We've seen Xeo going to for his up B edge guard, like trying to push Griffiths off his recovery trajectory. But since Bayonetta never goes into her free-fall animation, I'm not sure if this is actually a valid strategy, as at one point the platform came to help Griffiths, so it might actually be handy at one point, I suppose. But right there, it just allowed Griffiths to get back on stage even more safely than with his regular recovery.
Yeah, but the point is, like, at some point she cannot make no more a B or side B or anything.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm pretty sure he just wanted to push her away as far as he can, but... But now it's time. So 1-1. That's gonna be a full set on Smashville, I think. Oh, he moved with that side B, and finally Griffith crossed it. So it's gonna be some punish. Elixir making some zoning right now. Nice grab on that landing.
Elixir playing his usual keep away game, staying like four or five characters lengths away from his opponent, and with Bayonetta it's a really good strategy. You need to play very defensive and conservative against her.
Nice throw, but the air dodge, allowing him to move really far away.
He will not get punished. Yeah, he was a little too thirsty with his F smash. He probably read the second hit of the side B.
Whoop. Wow, that side B just getting away so fast. Just saw a jab and side B. Nice by Griffith, still catching him. Completely catch that jump.
Wow, this counter.
Not
sure
about that.
Again,
you.
No punish.
Elixir didn't get hit at all by Witch Time on the second match.
Yeah, actually that's true. And even when he got hit on the first match, it was at a very low percent.
Nice side B, a B, but won't be enough to get the kill, but still moving away. And now the Sash Spike!
Good edge guard by Griffiths, allowing him to take his first stock without too much of a deficit. Nice take chase, but does not convert because he was a little slow on the dash grab, perhaps not confident enough.
Nice side B, but nice forward to catch that land. Still pushing him with that shuriken. Still not in a rush to punish the landing. He knew he's gonna witch time on this one. Nice throw.
This pivot grab from so far away. And yeah, it seems like Griffiths has given up on the multi-hit part of his combo, which is FB. He just goes for a side kick. And as I was saying that, sometimes you just gotta go for it if that's the only option you got.
Nice up B.
Wow, this could get him punished badly.
Two. Oh!
Does not kill.
Really close. Oh, gets him on that jump.
And Alexeo cannot be happy about that. If he had permanent lag for only one or two moves, one or two hits, he might have taken the start with the up throw, just like that.
Nice at Beba Griffith. Getting him that a be nice bullet just right after. Still making some percent. Spaced a bit. He knew you're gonna get punished, so side B on the all the way of the stage. Still on the ground.
Good pivot grab will get him a back throw.
Oh my god!
Strong back air to the face. Like the heel just dug so deeply into Greninja's poor skull.
Nice jab. But the side B, oh, and there it
goes. So much special dodges from both characters. Wow, the dive kick, such a strong and quick option to get out of combos.
Griffiths read the roll, but finally it was a little bit too earlier to punish that, too bad. Alexio making a really great job avoiding Griffith to get back on stage by those fair, now those shuriken.
Making good use of the smashing platform to get away from Greninja's pressure.
Oh, nice side B just right after that air dodge. Moving around, Alexio staying on the ground, but when jump, getting punished that side B just right after.
I wonder if Griffiths has managed to change something about his up B combos, which I doubt, or if it's just like Greninja's side B strategy on the combos is not 100% guaranteed, and this might actually come back to bite him later in the set, as we've seen that he's now taken a few of these openings with a full up B connecting.
Nice grab by Yu Xiao, nice upper right after bombing enough to get the kill. Side B allowing Griffith to, oh my god! Which time to up smash! And that's it. Unfortunately, Xiao was so close to get that stock with that up smash. Maybe he released it a little bit too late, allowing Benedetta to make that witch time, and that was it.
And we were talking about witch times, well, we got one right there, and it killed Xiao at only 80%, so he lost with a two stock deficit. Seems to be sticking to his guns.
And he managed to avoid it for like two sets in a row.
Yep.
Two match in a row, but unfortunately, at the end, those two match.
So, I could hear the bans by Griffiths. He banned both the Final Destination and Duck and Dog. So I guess he just really does not want to deal with Greninja's patient and, precise, far away, keep away game. He just wants to be a little closer than that, so, well, Alexeo had to go back to town and city.
Yeah, like he knew the combo of Bayonetta won't be as efficient as maybe all the Bayonetta or on Greninja. It won't get killed earlier with those combo, but the reverse is true. With all those uppers, all those up throw that just send Alexeo earlier, he can get some kill way earlier than he could on the previous stage.
So it looks like a very solid pick. We'll see if it goes this way. For now, it really is looking this way because Griffiths is struggling to land and has a 100% deficit.
Oh wow, that down tilt unfortunately out of range!
Wow, tried to read the spot dodge but just a little too slow so did not react in time.
Alexio waiting in his shield in the center of the stage and get that air dodge with that up air and get the first stock of that match.
This was beautiful by Greninja, by Alexio, going for the spot dodge at the exact time that Griffiths went for his grab, which he hasn't gone for too much in the rest of this match. And got obviously the up throw to wait and then double jump up there.
Nice, get the roll with that side B, double up there, and finally won't be enough to make more, but he went on that air dodge.
Yeah. He's definitely adapting his combos to his opponent's DIs and their options, but does not manage to find too much success off of them for now.
Nice! Oh, nice throw. Oh! Some invisibility frame on that witch time, allowing Griffith to avoid that throw.
How's it called? Well, the bat within actually coming into play, allowing Bayonetta to avoid some stuff with late frames of air dodges and witch time.
Too bad he missed it, but still getting on the ground first. A nice F2 by Alexiao. Bayonetta trying to get back on stage, but catching her with that grab, but unfortunately don't get that upper. Get some bullets on your face, and...
Wow.
What?
Alexiao held down on his seat because he really didn't want to go on stage and get punished because Greninja is fairly laggy on the ground after his FB. So he tried to go for the edge, but held down for too long and just didn't grab the edge at all. Yeah, tries to go reach time, but as we've said, it's an area of effect around Bayonetta, and Greninja was way too far away to get slowed down.
Alexiao going back on the all the way of the stage, on the other side of the stage. Catch Bayonetta on that side with that forward there, but won't be enough to get the kill, of course. All on the right to go on the left. But that up throw. Now the up air! Two stock to one. Nice cross of that neutral air.
Wow, tries to read or something for the tech chase, but actually reads the wrong option. Alexiao playing his patient game.
Nice throw. Oh, the tilt. Nice up B just before landing on that side B. He knew he could have been punished by Alexiao. And like a B coming pretty fast. Was nice. Too bad.
Whoa, nice one. Well, definitely read the attempt by Griffiths to punish his landing. So mixed it up by doing a double jump down air.
Was 90. Nice side B catching him. I've been now, but seeing him too far away.
Wait, he seems to be scared when he goes for his upbeats. He's not committing anymore. So even when Alexiao is not using his side B, he's not continuing his combos, and not converting into all the damages that he wants.
Nice coming back on stage by Griffiths. Oh, really avoiding really well those shuriken, I got to say. Too bad he missed it, but still catching him on that side B. Nice throw. Oh, not another one. And this time, oh,
gets stuck, but still manages to make it back with a reverse up B. Reverse control air will send back. Alexiao off stage, and the platform assist right at the good time. Griffiths cannot be happy about that.
Top platform, Alexiao staying on the ground, just catching that up there, and that will be enough. 2-2.
Very decisive win again. In the last two matches, every time one of the players won, it was like by a two-stock margin. So I wonder what's exactly happening in this player's head. Is it like just adaptation or just not finding the openings they need? From what we've seen, Griffiths is definitely not taking advantage of Bayonetta's huge strength with his her heavy combos and kills off the top. So this match actually hurt him in the long run. Because on his part, Alexiao has managed to find very early kills just like that up air at just below or over 100%.
Nice pressure. So we're back on Smash VR.
Not too surprised there.
Too bad, reached the shield a bit earlier, missed the second side B.
Griffiths reads the roll, but right now Bayonetta's slow movement options are coming into play. Her specials allow her for very quick movement around the stage, but other than that, her move speed and run speed are actually fairly average, even below that.
Nice shuriken, probably. Griffiths missed it. Mrs. Shelley won't say.
That's a fair one. This is looking tough for Griffiths. And the up smash! Nice read by Alexiao. He's noticed the recovery patterns by Griffiths. Sometimes going for the edge with a B, and sometimes going over the edge with a rising side B. And this time, again, for the second time in this set, he's waiting for him with an up smash and killed him for it.
And what an important stock. Only 10%. And Griffiths already behind one stock. And Alexiao showing how patient he is. Harder and harder. Nice! Oh, too bad, hashtag. Oh la la, just putting him on that platform for him, don't make the punish. But Griffith making quite a good move, but the side B changing the situation. Oh, nice pivot grabbing you, Elixir, who's gonna run on him. Nice side B to get back on the center of the stage.
Okay, goes for side B, so little reward off of that. Griffith is really struggling in this matchup.
Oh, he wanted so bad, but Elixir always in movement now, it's gonna be way harder for Griffith to catch him. Nope.
Nice one, he will not punish Elixir with side B.
He catch a lot of those rolls, that side B, more and more. Like Griffith making a side B where Elixir gonna roll and then fast fall back here and catch him just right after out of his roll.
Nice back here. And was it like an up tilt to back here? Anyway, Griffith really needed that because he was struggling to kill Elixir, he is getting closer and closer to this specific percent range. Again, Elixir managing to take off Griffith's stock with only 100% on the counter.
Double side B, nice up tilt and up there. But you get a read. Wow, Elixir making a lot of throw and a lot of little move, poking a bit Griffith.
Yep, and we'll not get comboed off of it, even though at some specific ranges, Greninja can convert. And right there, we nearly saw the Sakurai effect. Here, take those 3 frames of landing lag off your frontier, Greninja, so that you can do frontier to frontier for a clean 27%.
Nice back here. Elixir getting back, getting catch by that double up here, but that up B of course won't get the kill. So Griffith avoiding that forward smash, really important. Some jabs, the side B, but of course Elixir not dead yet, but get that tech, get trumped. No more, nothing more.
Up here might have been it, and the frame trap goes on and on. This time goes for the frontier. Well, this is so tense. Griffith is really in a world of hurt. If he gets rid of this stock right now, he could still make it, even though Elixir has been very precise with his kills.
Nothing is over, nothing is over. Griffith went for info, limits the back, and maybe for quite nothing. Stay on this shield, trying to witch time, trying to bait Elixir. Side B, upper, and last match, last stock. Griffith now that's 100% behind Elixir, can't still make him that huge combo, but Elixir get the throw, get the landing punish, and fully miss the forward smash. Griffith, wait a bit.
Whoa, what was that second dash attack? I'm not too sure.
Elixir made that strong punish, that forward smash, and qualified himself for the loser final. Griffith get fourth, and at least top 3.